Hello, my name's Kody. I'm a first-year student here at Mohawk College in the TV broadcasting program. Now, between the control room and this large studio, which you see me filming in now, we've got numerous amounts of equipment that may be scary when you're first starting, but that's why I'm here to help you. My friend Taylor over here is going to help you teach you the lighting board. Taylor.
Hi, my name's Taylor, and I'm a first-year television broadcast student, and today I'm going to show you how the ETC Element Lighting Board works, the main points of it, why it's important, and why you should know it here in the studio.
When you first come to the large studio, located in F-Wing FO80, you're going to want to turn on the lights located near the back exit doors right of the studio. These are your house lights. They turn the main lights off in the room. Above these lights, we have the bright lights. The bright lights control the studio lights above the green screen. Importantly, right next to these lights, we have our stage lights. This will determine whether or not the lights for the stage will come on and off. Next, you're going to have to turn on the board. Just a button in the top corner, it will light up blue when on. Make sure your monitors are on. To turn them on, just click the little button in the bottom corner. This is your grandmaster. The grandmaster controls the overall intensity of the lights on the board. Make sure it is always up or your lights will not be working. If you notice the button above it, the blackout, is lit up, this means your lights will not be working. Make sure there's no red light. The lighting board has channels. 1 through 40, 41 through 80, and 81 through 120. Above our stage are rafters. On these rafters, there's a grid line. These grid lines have a light hanging from it that has a number. And that's how you know what light you want to turn on. For example, this one is 23. Now on to cues. A cue is a preset time for lights to go on and off with a single button. To record a cue, make sure to have your lights set to a desired intensity and selection. Press record, cue, then select a number to assign a numbered cue. To delete a cue, you must select the following keys in order. Delete, cue, then the number of cues you want to delete. Once you've entered the command, it will ask you to confirm. Press enter to confirm. Now we're going to assign a submaster. A submaster is a recorded set of lights assigned to a single fader on the board. To record a submaster, you must first have your lights and your intensity set to a preferable level. Once you have your lights set, press record and press any of the buttons under a fader to assign a submaster. Press stop to reset the submaster and bring the submaster fader up to turn on the lights. To delete a submaster, press the delete button, then press the button underneath the selected submaster to choose the submaster that you wish to delete. After you've chosen the submaster, the screen will ask you to confirm. Press enter to confirm. These are the LED lights. To select the LED lights, type the command 201 through 212 to select the LEDs. If the selection screen does not appear up on the screen, press the browser button to bring up the color wheel that with the preset modes. The computer has preset colors such as blue, red, pink, and more. You also have the ability to make custom colors by using the color wheel. Being the lighting person is a very important job. This ensures that the production is clean, crisp, and looks wonderful. Without proper lighting, no one can do the CCU. Lighting is the base of all shows. Without proper lighting, no one looks good.
Thank you, Taylor, for teaching our first years how to use the lighting board. And now, you first years, you know how to operate this lighting board. Good job.